guys? Welcome to another Home Free Friday. As always, if you enjoy the kind of content I'm putting out, feel free to like, comment, subscribe down below, share with your friends, all that good stuff. But today we've got something that I am super excited for. This is going to be their Alabama sampler, which I can only imagine is going to be an amazingly awesome, epic, home free medley of all kinds of country and southern rock songs. Probably, maybe, all bands that are from Alabama, or maybe they just use Alabama because it goes well with the word sampler and it's just southern stuff. I don't know, but I know either way it's going to be awesome. Home Free's medleys, their transitions, they're so good. Like, I don't know if I've asked this before, and if somebody watching this right now has been like, I commented an answer to this, you know, several videos ago. I'm sorry, I must not have seen it. But who does Home Free's arrangements? Like, is it the five of them? Is it like one or two of them? Do they have an outside guy come in? Because I would be very interested in learning that, because they're so good. Ah. But either way, yeah, this is going to be some kind of medley, and it's Home Free, and it's going to be awesome. So let's go ahead and get into it.
Play me some mountain music, like grandma and grandpa used to play, and I'll float on down the river to a Cajun hideaway. Hey, hey, hey.
God, that's so good.
Creeks and cool mountain mornings, honest work out in the fields, cornbread in my mama's kitchen, daddy saying grace before the meal.
Family ties run deep in this land,
and I'm never very far.
You gotta have a fiddle in the band. That lead guitar is
hard. God, I love Rob.
So rousing up that bow for faded love, and let's all dance. If you're gonna play in Texas, you gotta have a fiddle in the band.
In the band, oh yeah. White-tailed buck deer munching on clover. Red-tailed hawk sitting on a rail. Chubby old groundhog, croaking.
Free as a feeling in the wind, lucky as a seven, living in heaven, yeah, with my Dixieland delight. Spend my dollar,
ooh,
parked in a holler neath the mountain moonlight.
Our darkest hours,
with a light of love.
To guide us with a light of love.
Aww. That was so beautiful. God, I love these guys so much. All right, let's get big.
So yeah, let me be the first to say that that was not quite what I was expecting. I don't know why. Maybe I was just expecting it to be maybe faster or something like that. But that was really, really good. That was really beautiful. I'm actually kind of surprised. I knew like, well, didn't know. I'd heard like three of the songs of the God knows how many they actually used in that one. Because, again, the transitions were so good, so crispy, that I really couldn't even tell when songs were switching. Like, God, their arrangements are so good. And Rob and Austin, again, they are just... God, those two guys' voices. I mean, I can't think of, I mean, other than, like, you know, Superfruit, like Mitch and Scott from Pentatonix. I can't think of another two people whose voices go together so well. I love it. I love watching it. It's such a treat. But I do have to ask, though, are they all, like, actual country fans? Or was, like, for one or two of them, was it just kind of like a job? You know, just like, yeah, I'll join your group. I'll do whatever. Or do they actually find five dudes that were, like, big, giant country fans? I know, like, one or two of them, I thought, were from, like, California or something like that. Like, only one is still from Minnesota, which is fine. But is it maybe, like an Avi Kaplan and Pentatonix situation where he really loves, like, folkier music, but, you know, when given the opportunity, he did Pentatonix and he rocked it and he killed it in the time that he was there? Or are they, yeah, literally just big country fans, like, for life? I don't know. There wasn't a whole lot of Tim in this one, which, you know, Tim used to be the only reason why I loved Home Free. It was like, oh my God, it's so good. His bass is absolutely amazing. And then I started hearing more songs where he wasn't necessarily featured really prominently. And I was just, and still am, just amazed that I still enjoy those songs just as much. Like everybody else, they're so good. As a team, you really don't get much better in, you know, acapella music. It's so good. And it was a nice simple video too, where you got to see everybody, you know, doing their thing. All it looked like a church / music studio. I don't know. I know I've seen old churches be turned into like living like places, like houses and stuff like that. So maybe someone did turn into like a studio. That'd be a neat thing to go check out. But Adam, though, like both Adams, Adam beatboxer and Adam singer, because yeah, it's back when they had Adam, not Chance. Adam singer really, 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 really impressed me there at the end when it was just Adam, Austin, and Rob, kind of when everything slowed down. Very, very beautiful. Very beautiful. And then Adam, beatboxer Adam, is just, it's like he swallowed a drum set, you know, when he was a kid, and he's just been, you know, mastering his craft ever since. It just doesn't make any sense. But damn. Yeah, not quite what I thought for the Alabama sampler, but did not detract from it at all. God, these guys are talented. I love it. But yeah, no, thank you guys so much for stopping by, checking it out. Happy Home Free Friday. If you guys like this, you know, let me know like your favorite kind of covers that they did in this song. I'd love to read it. Otherwise, yeah, you guys have an excellent rest of your day, and I will see you in the next reaction.